Apple's latest and greatest handset comes with a higher price tag not only for the device, but also for AppleCare Plus coverage. You should still buy it, and AppleInsider explains why. When pre-orders for the iPhone X opened, it only took 10 minutes for shipments of Apple's flagship device to slip beyond the scheduled November 3rd launch date. It only took 1 hour before shipping estimates for all carriers rose to 4 to 5 weeks. It's not surprising, since the hotly anticipated iPhone X redesign boasts Apple's first edge-to-edge OLED screen, as well as advanced facial recognition technology. Production of the screen and Face ID sensors are believed to be the main reasons for supply shortages of the iPhone X. Dropping and shattering your iPhone screen isn't the same anymore. On the iPhone X, you now run the risk of damaging the Face ID sensors, and without that, you've pretty much got a cracked iPhone 8, but without Touch ID, leaving a manually entered code as your only means of unlocking the device. To make it even worse, if you don't have AppleCare Plus, it'll cost you $279 to replace the screen. That's $110 more than on the iPhone 8 Plus. And if you can't afford that, you're stuck with an iPhone X that can't even use its most important feature. On top of that, it costs $549 for other iPhone repairs like liquid damage. That's more than half the price of the phone, and $150 more than on the 8 Plus. Although AppleCare Plus costs $199 for the iPhone X, it's only $50 more than on the 8 Plus, and it's even more worth it since you're protecting the precious Face ID sensors. Even though an iPhone X screen replacement costs $110 more than on the 8 Plus, you still pay the same $29 premium with AppleCare Plus as you'd pay for any other iPhone. And the same goes for serious iPhone damage, paying the same $99 as for any other iPhone. Users who don't like using cases and trust themselves enough to not need AppleCare Plus should really think twice when it comes to the iPhone X. Anything could happen, and you could be left with broken Face ID sensors. The $199 price for AppleCare Plus might sound a little bit hefty, but if you factor in no longer needing a screen protector and case, that's a minimum savings of $60 if you're buying directly from Apple. But of course, it's cheaper if you're buying from a third party like Amazon. If you're planning on buying AppleCare Plus, you should definitely be buying the iPhone X using Apple's iPhone Upgrade Program. It's basically an interest-free loan, so you'll pay exactly the same amount as you would if you bought the combo outright. So that means the $199 for AppleCare Plus becomes $8.29 a month, the same price as a couple coffees. The best part of the deal is that you can upgrade to next year's newest iPhone release, completely free of charge. The iPhone X with included AppleCare Plus and free iPhone upgrades every year will run you just under $50 a month before taxes. You may be thinking that you can get a monthly payment plan through your service provider, but are you sure they don't charge interest for the loan? Apple doesn't. So why not buy AppleCare Plus through Apple's iPhone Upgrade Program? In the end, you'll still end up paying the same amount of cash, except your bank account will be a heck of a lot happier in the meantime.
If you enjoyed this video, like it and hit that subscribe button. Also, check out our price guide, which makes it extremely easy to find the best deals on Apple products updated daily. Be sure to follow us on social media, and we'll see you in the next video.